was 16. Yeah, just the fact that I was able to, like, have my feet wet, you know, get my feet settled, like, mentally be, like, clear, you know, emotionally be kind of free in that piece is, like, with my decision and have an opportunity to, like, plan, you know, proper plan, the situation, being able to kind of draw out and have those goals and see that picture and vision of what this could look like, what this could be. Whereas before, it was everything for me felt like it was rushed. It happened at the 25th hour. Like, it was just, I didn't have an opportunity to like go into the situation and really have a great understanding of what was needed for me and what I needed to do. And so I was learning on the fly almost. Whereas now this, you know, I had an opportunity to go to the Bahamas and be with the team. And also for the team to see where I'm at, you know, physically, mentally, play with the guy, you know, play on the court with the guys, play pickup, workout, and for everybody to see my mentality and where I'm at right now. And then like my focus level when it comes to playing basketball and working and trying to win a championship is at a high level right now.
This is Melo talking about his transition.
It wasn't forced. Like, it was a natural fit for everybody. And we was able to go down there, enjoy ourselves, have fun. We trained together. We played, you know, we played pickup together. But also we approached it as if it was a real mini camp, right? Guys had to really be in shape and get in shape and, you know, communicate and talk about, you know, what our goals are and then go out there and play. And, but for the most part, everything off the court, like the way that guys were bonding, you know, I know it was only a couple of days, but anytime you're in a place like the Bahamas, like you almost, you have to bond, you know what I mean? You have to bond with your guys. So it was just good for everybody from the rookies and young guys to the veterans to just be around, you know, one another. Have an opportunity to prepare. It's basketball to me at the end of the day. I think knowing, coming into the situation, what that role is and what my role is and what I have to do, it makes things a lot easier. I'm not trying to figure it out on the fly. I'm trying to make adjustments as we go on. Like, I know what this team expects of me. I know what I expect of myself. And that's it. It's basketball that people do. Huh? To win a championship. And that's it. I mean, it's at this point, that's the only thing that really, really matters. And everything that happens along the way, as far as, you know, having the right preparation, preparing yourself to go out there and get ready for a long season. My role is to make sure that the guys on the team understand and know that this is a long, long season. Like, this is not, you know, we're not going to win a championship in the first week of the season, right? We got to prepare. We got to take those steps. But also, at the end of the day, we know what we're here for, right? I don't think nobody is thinking anything differently than trying to win a championship. I'm not, you know, I haven't had that conversation yet, you know, with anybody. But like I said, everything that I've been talking to people and talked about too, like I'm very clear on what my role is. Yeah, he put a lot of pressure on me. I'm not even gonna lie. He called me. I was on vacation with my family in South Africa, and he's like, "Look, I'm not gonna sugarcoat anything. Like, we haven't won without you, but if we win with you, then that makes all the difference." But For me, it was just more of like hearing his excitement for me being a part of this team and this organization, and you know, his vision of what he wanted to accomplish and what he, you know, how he believed in me as a person and as a basketball player. Say it again. The opportunity itself, and knowing how close this team is to winning the championship. We all watched. I've watched from afar and saw how close this team was last year. Injury here, a couple shots here, like we could be talking a different story. But at the end of the day, we can't live off of that. Like, we got to go back to work. You know what I mean? Like, we have to put the work back in. And we have to continue, you know, what was created last year, but also understand that this journey is a long, long journey. And we can't try to go do it in one day or 1 week.
Well, there it is. And nobody's talking about them. Nobody's talking about the Houston Rockets. Though people believe that they were one CP injury away from the NBA Finals, which I said they still would have lost. And they still will lose this year. People give them a percentage of 9%. Okay, Golden State Warriors are predicted to win the NBA championship again, but going to represent the NBA Finals. In the East, Boston is a favorite. Huge favorite. They're an 80% chance of going to the NBA Finals. People still have the 76ers up there, neck and neck with Toronto. Golden State is at 90-some percent chance to go to the NBA Finals. 90-some percent chance of winning. But it's balancing out against Boston. It is. Where a lot of people are starting to bet Boston could actually beat them. So the way this season's starting right now, they even got Klay Thompson over there promoting Boston. Like, oh, the team that could give us the team in Boston right now, more than anybody, gives us a greater challenge. Basically omitting all the teams in the West. Yeah, this is going to be crazy, y'all. Strap up. But why is no one talking about Houston? Where are the Rocket fans at?